Random House Audio presents the Knopf National Poetry Month Collection.
This is David Young. I'll be reading Black Labrador. 1. Churchill called his bad visits from depression a big black dog. We have reversed that, Winston. We've named him Nemo. No one. A black hole where light is gulped. Invisible by night. By day, when light licks everything to shine, a black silk coat ablaze with inky shade. He's our black lab, wherein mad scientists concoct excessive energy. It snows, and he bounds out, inebriate of cold. The white flakes settle on his back and neck and nose and make a little universe. 2. It's best to take God backward. Even sideways, he is too much to contemplate. A deep but dazzling darkness, as Vaughan says. And so I let my Nemo omen lead me onward and on toward that deep dark I'm meant to enter, entertain when my time comes. The day wheels past, a creaky cart. I study the rippling anthracite that steadies me, the tar, the glossy licorice, the sable. And in this snowfall that I should detest, late March and early April, I'm still rapt to see his coat so constellated, starred, restarred, making a comic cosmos I can love.
Joan Didion will read two stanzas by Gerard Manley Hopkins.
I wake and feel the fell of dark, not day. What hours, oh, what black hours we have spent this night. What sights you saw, ways you went, and more must, in yet longer light's delay. With witness I speak this, but where I say hours, I mean years, mean life. And my lament is cries countless, cries like dead letters sent to dearest him that lives, alas, away. I am gall, I am heartburn. God's most deep decree, bitter would have me taste, my taste was me. Bones built in me, flesh filled, blood brimmed the curse, self yeast of spirit, a dull dough sours. I see the lost are like this, and their scourge to be, as I am mine, their sweating selves, but worse.
Sarah Arvio will read Colosseum from her book Sono.
That was the blood again, the self-same spot that had to go, which didn't mean the rose, though blood in a rose could share a color. It rose to my face, as a blush would do, for showing you that I was what I was. I was the empress, or else the goddess, or the servant of my sensual thoughts, and I threw all my meat to the lions, to be eaten alive, or lionized. A colossal mess I made of my life, in the flesh and also in the round. This was the essence of Colosseum, the museum of my colossal shame, where I mused on the blood sport of it all, where I longed for the lust of the lions. Here was my game, the name of my sin, for I never threw men to the lions, or rose from my lair, or ate men like air, or pearls to the pigs, though I tossed a rose to the crowds and begged them to spare my life, dominion and dungeon of the senses, and all the beauty and the blasphemy. Petals, petals, scattering from the stands where only vestals were allowed to sit, having tended the flame for all of us. Here I knew was the empire of my soul, showing on my face as I turned to you.
Deborah Garrison will read a poem called Untitled by Jane Mayhall.
The closest thing I can remember about your kiss, it was like a breeze. I blanked out when you got close. It was sensual. It was not sensual. No compromise or plan. a whorled, airy unintention, some nowhere of the softest passing through, like a window opening. I can't remember lips, but felt them, cool and warm, untitled, like a breeze.
Kevin Young will read The Grift from his book Black Mariah.
On his back, he lugged around his life, stuffed into a croaker sack, full as a thought balloon in some cartoon. Flim-flam man, $7 and a plan. His face looked like a pool table, deep pockets for eye sockets, faded red, but felt was something he never did. Flim-flam man, 10 fingers and a plan. His real home was 6 feet beneath ground. He was just up here renting breath with the rest of us. Short-term lease he's fallen behind on. Flim-flam man, 2 empty hands.
J.D. McClatchy will read The Ledger from his book Hazmat.
Love is injustice, said Camus. We want to be loved. What's still more true? Each wants most to be preferred, and listens for those redeeming words, better than X, more than Y. Enough to quiet the child's cry, the bridegroom's nerves, the patient's reluctant belief in providence. Break what you can, hurt whom you will, humiliate the others until someone takes a long, hard look. Oh, love, put down your balance book.
This is a recording of James Merrill reading his poem, The Broken Home.
Crossing the street, I saw the parents and the child at their window, gleaming like fruit with evening's mild gold leaf. In a room on the floor below, sunless, cooler, a brimming saucer of wax, marbly and dim, I have lit what's left of my life. I have thrown out yesterday's milk and opened a book of maxims. The flame quickens, the word stirs. Tell me, tongue of fire, that you and I are as real, at least as the people upstairs. My father, who had flown in World War I, might have continued to invest his life in cloud banks well above Wall Street and Wife. But the race was run below, and the point was to win. Too late now, I make out in his blue gaze, through the smoked glass of being 36, the soul eclipsed by twin black pupils, sex and business. Time was money in those days. Each 13th year he married. When he died, there were already several chilled wives in sable orbit, rings, cars, permanent waves. We'd felt him warming up for a green bride. He could afford it. He was in his prime at 80. But money was not time. When my parents were younger, this was a popular act. A veiled woman would leap from an electric wine-dark car to the steps of no matter what, the Senate or the Ritz bar, and bodily, at newsreel speed, attack no matter whom, Al Smith or José María Sert or Clemenceau, veins standing out on her throat as she yelled, "Warmongerer pig, give us the vote," and would have to be hauled away in her hobble skirt. What had the man done? Oh, made history. Her business, he had implied, was giving birth, tending the house, mending the socks. Always that same old story. Father Time and Mother Earth, a marriage on the rocks. One afternoon, red satyr-thighed Michael, the Irish setter, head passionately lowered, led the child I was to a shut door. Inside, blinds beat sun from the bed.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.